War. War never changes. In the year 1945, my great-great-grandfather, serving in the army, wondered when he'd get to go home to his wife and the son he'd never seen. He got his wish when the U.S. ended World War II by dropping atomic bombs on Hiroshima and Nagasaki. The world awaited Armageddon. Instead, something miraculous happened. We began to use atomic energy not as a weapon, but as a nearly limitless source of power. People enjoyed luxuries once thought the realm of science fiction. Domestic robots, fusion-powered cars, portable computers. But then, in the 21st century, people awoke from the American dream. Years of consumption led to shortages of every major resource. The entire world unraveled. Peace became a distant memory. It is now the year 2077. We stand on the brink of total war. And I am afraid. For myself. For my wife. For my infant son. Because of my time in the army taught me one thing. It's that war. War never changes. War never changes.
You're gonna knock him dead at the Veterans Hall tonight, hon.
You think?
Absolutely. Now get ready and stop hogging the mirror.
Right.
Nice. Did you get a haircut?
Honey, you think my nose is too big?
Stop!
Hansons?
How'd I do the fake? Wow, what that time is right there, bro. Seriously.
Harry Ball and the morning.
Ah! Mustache, huh? My turn, big guy.
God, she's like Halle Berry.
Let me just slide in here.
Hey.
Okay, come on.
Yes, it's not really the best, man.
Just another minute, I swear.
Halle Berry, Halle Berry.
Ah, good morning, sir. Your coffee. 173.5 degrees Fahrenheit. Room to perfection.
Thanks, Cosmo.
You know, I was nervous at first, but Codsworth is really good with Sean.
Yeah. Yeah, small ass TV, man. God damn.
Hey, hon.
We should take Codsworth to be serviced soon, don't you think? It's probably that salesman. He comes from you every day.
Enjoy your coffee,
that's your baby.
Codsworth.
Don't worry about the dishes. That's my job.
All right.
Come on, just answer the door.
Good morning. Vault-Tec calling.
Okay.
Whatever you're selling, I'm not buying.
No, no worries, sir. No worries at all. I'm not selling anything. Not today. You can't begin to know how happy I am to finally speak with you. I've been trying for days. It's a matter of utmost urgency, I assure you.
What's so important?
Why, nothing less than your entire future. If you haven't noticed, sir, this country has gone to heck in a handbasket. If you'll excuse my language, the big kaboom is... It's inevitable, I'm afraid. And coming sooner than you may think, if you catch my meaning. Now, I know you're a busy fellow, so I won't take up much of your time. Time being a precious commodity. I'm here today to tell you that because of your family service to our country, you have been pre-selected for entrance into the local vault. Vault 111.
Sounds great.
Oh, it is. Believe you me. Now, you're already cleared for entrance in the unforeseen event of total atomic annihilation. I just need to verify some information. That's all.
Come back some other time.
Come on, hon. It's just a little paperwork. Let him fill it out, and it's done.
I said no.
And I'm saying yes. So there.
Splendid! Splendid. Let's get to it. Wonderful. That's everything. I'm just gonna walk this over to the vault. Congratulations on being prepared for the future.
Thanks again.
Hey, it's peace of mind. That's worth a little paperwork, right?
For you and Sean, no price is too high.
Good answer.
I have my moments.
God damn, she was so bad.
Sean has been changed. He absolutely refuses to calm down.